Good afternoon, everyone.
Welcome to our Nabe party. My name is Chihiro Yuki.
And my name is Masataka Tatsumi.
In one morning. Oh no, I overslept. I'll be late again.
You make our breakfast, it's ready.
I don't need anything. I don't have time, Mom.
Hello, everyone. We are going to talk about food replicas. So let us begin.
Oh, I'm hungry.
I brought you a souvenir from Kyoto.
Oh, thank you. Wow, it's so beautiful.
Hello, everyone. Yuichiro Kaneyasu and Ippei Hoshi give a presentation, Prigra, the modern Bijinga.
Hey, Jin, I feel so stressed recently. Preparing for this competition, I even can't sleep well at night.
I see, you are under a lot of pressure.
Yinyue, the red leaves in Kyoto are so beautiful.
Yes, they are. And you know, it's my first time to see the red leaves in Kyoto.
Then today, we are going to talk about manners and the features of the center. It is estimated that 90% of Japanese...
Hello everyone, my name is Shinsuke Nakayama.
And my name is Ijo Lee, but you can call me Vera.
We came from Kochi and we bought you a souvenir.
The Golden Bat. Story number 16 will begin. Poor girl Masae was caught by the gang of Nazo.
The fourth prize Sakamoto Sensei will be presenting. That goes to experience the Japanese bento culture. Gyo Ryu and Etsuin. Please.
Look, Yinyue, the red leaves in Kyoto are so beautiful.
Yes, they are. And you know, it's my first time to see the red leaves in Kyoto.
Really?
Yes. And you know, I'm thinking it could be nice to look at the view and get something to eat at the same time.
Are you hungry?
A little.
Okay. But let me show you some Japanese bentos. You can choose one, and I'm sure you'll like it.
Okay, that sounds good.
Look, these are the bentos that Japan has passed on to the world. These bentos are from Thailand, United States, Brazil, and China.
Oh yes, in China we call bento he fan, which has the meaning of a box containing food.
And now for the third prize winners. The third prize winners will receive the Mainichi Daily News Cup, and the winners are Purikura, the modern Bijinga, Ippei Hoshi and Yuichiro Kaneyasu. Yes, well done.
Hello everyone. Yuichiro Kaneyasu and Ippei Hoshi give a presentation, Purikura, the modern Bijinga.
Although it's been quite a while since Purikura became a social phenomenon in Japan, they have maintained popularity, especially among high school girls. At first, the functions of Purikura were limited to taking photos and adding a few simple embellishments. But now, Purikura provide the capacity to alter photos and change someone's appearance dramatically to such an extent that the original image is almost unrecognizable. To demonstrate, we took Purikura photo using the default functions and came out like this. As you can see, our eyes, especially his eyes, became bigger and skin wider. Why are these kinds of functions so popular and prevalent? As we study the inclination for this face-changing function, we came out to a surprising realization. Women want to come out beautiful and cute, even if the image in the picture does not convey their actual appearance.
Now, the second prize. The second prize winners today will receive Mainichi Daily News Cup, slightly bigger, and the winners of these prizes are from Omusubi, an everlasting Japanese bond, Yumeko Akashi and Ayaka Matsuoka.
in one morning.
Oh no, I overslept. I'll be late again.
You may go. Breakfast is ready.
I don't need anything. I don't have time, Mom.
You need to eat something. Here, take this omusubi with you.
Thank you, Mom. See you later.
Have a good day, sweetie. See ya.
Second, omusubi can represent a mother's love.
Omusubi, Japanese rice balls, are most often made with salt on the surface, and umeboshi, a pickled plum, inserted inside. They are wrapped with seaweed. In the present day, they are frequently eaten at the school excursions, on sports days, and as a light meal when you don't have time.
Although Japanese today have various choices for food, omusubi have still sustained popularity. This is because omusubi have not only played a role as food, they have function to tie or bond people together.
And so we come to the final prize, the first prize for the competition today. And these are the prizes that the winners can receive. The Marita Cup times two. Book tokens to the value of 30,000 yen each. Two round-trip air tickets to either London or New York City. Let's have a little drum roll before I give the final word. Minasan, onegaishimasu. Ready? Oh, in time, please. And the winners are Kamishibai, There Is Still Some Analog Culture in Japan.
The Golden Bat. Story number 16 will begin. Poor girl Masae was caught by the gang of Nazo. So this is the daughter of the doctor Masae. Now, tell me the secret of the disruptive beam. I don't know, sir. Then, look at this. For father, Masaru, you're both alive. She'd been worried of them for a long time. When she saw them on TV, she felt released, and her eyes were filled with big teardrops. Well, what is Mr. Golden Bat doing now? Mr. Golden Bat! Oh no, it was not enough. Everyone, please help Masae and call Mr. Bat together. Ready? One, two, three! Mr. Golden Bat! Masae and your voices reach him, perhaps. The echoing voice through the mountains of Alps. It must be the Golden Bat. The Golden Bat, friend of justice. The Golden Bat hates the evil and punishes the wickedness. The friend of justice, the Golden Bat, here I am. What's gonna happen next? Continuous will be on the next week. Till then, see ya. Kang, 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 kang. And this is Kamishibai. And this is what we are going to talk about today. What we can do with this is to tell stories. Long time ago, storytellers rode their bicycle and performed Kamishibai.
Kamishibai has connection with one of the famous Japanese culture, manga. Unlike manga, Kamishibai is not so popular in Japan now.
However, some people believe in the possibility that Kamishibai has. For example, one group
called Yasan Ichiza. Yasan Ichiza is one of the famous Kamishiba performance group in Japan. We interviewed them, and we would like to introduce three strong points that Kamishiba has.
The first one is education. Kamishiba is not the subject like math or science, but it is like a classes to learn about manners and common senses.
Here is one example. There are children from wide ranges of generation mixed among spectators. If taller children are sitting right in front of here or standing right over here, smaller children cannot see Kamishibai well. So taller children must think about smaller children.
These kind of situations help children to think of others. Kamishibai is of course enjoyable, but also it has some lessons in it.
The next strong point that Kamishibai has is communication. Kamishibai is one of the brilliant tools to improve communication skills. Communication skills.
For example, Kamishibai has some quizzes, and storytellers ask children what the answer is. Then children raise their hand immediately. But it is unusual in Japan, actually. But children do this. Why? Because they can get some prizes, whether they are correct or not.
Speed and speed back is extremely important for Kamishibai.
Speed and speed back means that when storyteller tells story loudly and spray spit, then the spectators talk to the storyteller loudly and spray spit back.
When it is happening, Kamishibai truly become Kamishibai.
And the final strong point of Kamishibai is imagination. Kamishibai has some technique to improve imagination. But what is it? We will show you two choices. One, the Fusuma Biki slide. The previous page hide the next page.
Number two, Kujibiki. Having some rotary to make children think what kind of goodies they can get. Which one is it? One or two?
The answer is
one. Showing only half page of Kamishibai makes children excited to think what is coming next. Also, question may help children to think and improve imagination by thinking flexibly the idea.
These kind of good points is cut. Sorry, these kind of points catch the attention not only from Japan but also from many other countries. For example, Yasan Ichiza got a lot of offers from many other countries. For example, America, the UK, and Korea to visit and perform Kamishibai.
As time has passed, these kinds of Kamishibai has increased.
And actually, Yasan Ichiza created some new types of Kamishibai.
One of them called Kamishibai without titles. These kind of Kamishibai created by children's imagination. We will show you one of them.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. So, who is this?
Anyone?
It's Santa Claus.
Yes.
Santa Claus visited a house and leave a present for a child. Then, child wake up. Oh my God, I get a present. What is it, what is it? What? Dynamite? Now, everyone, please count down together.
Let's
join us.
Five.
Four,
three, Santa. Now, back to the title of the presentation. Why do we need Anglo culture? We have TV, laptop, cell phones, and so many other digital things in our life. It seems that we don't need such a culture. But is this true? The answer is no. With the appearance of digital thing, many important things has disappeared within our culture, such as thinking of others and supporting each other. Of course, the digital things are important and useful, but it doesn't mean that analog things are not useful. There is a power that only analog own. Kamishibai is like a warm family. And when storyteller perform kamishibai, when storyteller perform kamishibai, and children are rude, they scold the children. And when children say something good or something funny or new, storyteller accepts it and praises children. Kamishibai take place of father and mother and tell children how to cope with society when you get older. If kamishibai disappears from Japan, what will happen to the children? And what will happen to Japan? The destiny of kamishibai is in our hand. Let's leave kamishibai for the next generation. We need kamishibai. What's going to happen to the future of kamishibai? And what's going to happen to the future of the children? Today's storytellers were Gumi Imamura and
Nanami Kaida from Kyoto University of Foreign Studies.
Thank you for your attention.